we even doing this, man?
Because it's important to practice the songs that sound good acoustically.
I don't want to.
We never do that. That's why I'm going to set aside one jam every 2.5 years to practice just that.
I don't see the point.
I just told you the point.
If I can play it for real, then I can play it acoustically. When I'm here, I want to play loud, man.
It's not going to kill you to pick up an acoustic guitar every once in a while.
But I play acoustic guitar all the time at home. That's why my amp is here.
Well, it also wouldn't kill me to play some acoustic drums.
They're always acoustic, Steve. Just hit them a little less hard. I mean, that shouldn't be that hard.
That's what I'm saying. It's not going to kill me to practice some ghost notes. I've pretty much never done that.
Okay, so you've established that none of this is going to kill you. Maybe you should practice it on your own time a little bit. You know, what do you do all day? Every day? Anyway.
Well, nothing really. Just listening to albums. Rocking out.
I'm Scott. I'm the coolest guy. And I don't even try.
Wait for you to get here. The usual stuff.
Well, actually, it's very simple, Steve.
Nothing weird. Nothing different than that.
If you just practice 10 ghost notes a day, then over the year, that's going to be 1,000 ghost notes. And then over 10 years, that's going to be 10,000 ghost notes that you've practiced. And imagine how good you would be now if you had done that 10 years ago.
Well, it's a little late for that now, isn't it? So how about you just humor me tonight? And then again, in 2.5 years. And then every 2.5 years after that. It's not too much to ask.
Okay, well, I will humor you tonight. And probably a few more nights in the future. But we can't do this every night.
Unplugged shows might get popular again.
I don't even care what's popular.
The MTV Unplugged shows were awesome.
MTV is not even a thing anymore.
Let's just do it!
Alright! Jeez! What song do you want to play first?
How about Polly?
There's no drums in that song.
There's crashes.
Only like 3. It might even only be 2.
I want to ease myself in.
Steve, I can play Polly alone at my house. You know why? There's no drums in that song. Okay? I come here to play drums with you. I mean, you play drums, I play guitar. If you're gonna make me play acoustic guitar when I'm here, all I ask is that you play drums too.
Okay, fine. How about Heaven Beside You?
Sure.
Set up my mic?
What the? What are you doing, man?
Well, what are you doing sleeping?
It's gross! Is that spit?
No! You were sleeping!
I wasn't sleeping! I was just resting my eyes!
Same thing!
By the way, I'm pretty tired. You know why? Because I've been working on the album every day, every night, I'm 24/7. I'm working on the album, so.
Well, I didn't tell you to give her so hard on the album that you'd be too tired to jam once you got here.
I'm always tired, man. I never get to sleep. Between the trains and the bum fights and the alley noise, I just can't sleep. So you know what I do? I work on our album all night long.
Well, I work on it all day long.
And you know what? When I come here, I'm going to be a little bit tired. I'm sorry. But here's why. It's because I care about our music so much. Like, so much.
So do I.
Are you on that level, Steve?
Yeah.
Are you caring about this music even close as much as I am?
Yeah. I just don't sacrifice my well-being over it. But I would.
I don't get to sleep in a soundproof room like you.
Yeah. I sleep like a baby. Every night.
Just shut up, man.
I love this room so much. We can't lose it.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. There's actually a 90s themed Battle of the Bands coming up this weekend. And they have an opening.
There can't be.
For one more band.
Where?
The Tractor.
That's a big venue.
I know.
What's going on here? A battle of the bands in my own town and I know nothing about it? Am I slipping in my old age?
Yeah, they didn't do a call out because they had the band set for the venue. But one of the bands had to cancel because of a car accident.
Nice.
Good news.
I'll say, battle of the bands usually means a cash prize.
Oh yeah, $2,000.
$2,000? Scott! You magnificent Melvin! You just made us $1,000 each!
Well, we haven't really won it yet. You're right, we got this in the bag.
Yeah, man.
There's no doubt. No doubt.
Oh, what other bands are competing? Anyone we know?
I don't know everyone who's gonna be there, but I know that Carrot and Krang is gonna be there.
No way!
And this is our chance to show them who's boss.
Man, this is perfect! They're always bragging about how they're good enough to headline at Brody's, but they don't get the chance because Rick likes us better, but now we can really knock them down a peg.
And this is our chance to prove once and for all who the best 90s grunge band is.
Well, we more or less prove it every week. But you know what though? Even though Craig and Darren are total posers, we could actually learn something from them.
No way.
Since we don't know anything about this show, it wouldn't hurt us to prepare a bit.
Hmm. You know I don't like the P word.
I hate to say this, but we should get ready to play Hold My Hand by Hootie and the Blowfish.
What? No way!
Trust me on this. It's strictly for insurance purposes in case the crowd is into cheesy stuff. We could use that money.
Well, we're not gonna win it that way.
I've noticed that people like that song a lot nowadays, and they're acting like it was cool in the 90s. But in reality, nobody liked it back then.
Probably because it's Hootie and the Blowfish.
No, their album, Cracked Rear View.
Which one's Hootie and which one's Blowfish?
Was insanely popular in the mid-90s, but it was really just the songs I Only Want to Be With You and Let Her Cry, and then to a lesser extent, Time, that were popular. And Hold My Hand was the first single, but it totally went under the radar. It's that Langella effect or whatever it is that's making people remember it differently and they think Hold My Hand was cool back then, but it wasn't.
Yeah, but like, can't we just win this battle of the bands legitimately instead of trying to trick them?
It's not tricking them. What if that new band from 90s Night is there? That one that's been playing all those Cranberries and Cardigans and Third Eye Blind songs. They've been getting really popular lately. I don't remember their name because they suck, but it's like that expression goes, for every action, there's an equal or greater reaction. Like for every song we play that rocks, they can play a song that sucks and the audience is still gonna like it for some reason.
Okay, so let them do it, you know, let them mess it all up because they got the wrong songs, the wrong way of performing it. They're all messed up and we're not.
I just think that it wouldn't hurt to show the crowd that we're well-rounded enough that we can also do wuss songs. Because you know Carrot and Krang are going to be doing all the cheesy songs.
So leave all those ones to them then. They can do all the lame songs, we'll do the good ones. Like Breed, Outshined.
Yeah, but what if the audience is a bunch of wimps?
Then I say we rock even harder. Pull them up by their own bootstraps. What if we play Smells Like Teen Spirit?
Out of the question!
Why?
You gonna make me waste my breath? Nirvana famously hated that song, so they just stopped playing it live. So we don't play it either.
Well, yeah. Obviously, I know that, Steve. And our fans know that. But this is going to be a different crowd. And everyone loves that song.
I know. They still beg us to play it at Brody's every month.
Probably every week.
Exactly. But we tell them no. Because we're staying faithful to Kurt. The Great One hated that song.
Well, it's true. I remember reading that. But, you know, did he really hate it? Because it's only after you play a song like thousands of times that you start to hate it. So he probably hated it because he played it like a million times.
Yeah, that's the exact reason why.
Or thousands of times.
But you remember when Rick kept asking us to play it?
Or a million, or billion.
What did I say to him?
I'd rather not repeat that, what you said to Rick.
Exactly. And he hasn't asked us since.
Yeah, I mean, I understand why we don't play it for our fans. Because it's kind of a bit poser-ish.
No kidding.
But here's the thing, man. If you want to win this thing, shouldn't we play something cool instead of something cheesy?
All right, fine. We're playing Neither.
Yes.
You happy?
Well, I mean, Neither? Maybe we should do...
But I'm telling you...
The cool one.
Carrot and Krang is going to be covering Blind Melon and R.E.M. and Wallflowers.
Okay, so let's try meeting somewhere in the middle then. Like a wussy song that still rocks. Counting Blue Cars by Dishwalla.
Hey, I kind of like that song. But no, not enough people know about it.
Oh!
I got it. Far Behind by Candlebox.
First, you asked me for Hootie and the Blowfish. Then you asked me for Candlebox. What's next? Oasis?
Hey! That's not called for. Show some respect for the local guys.
Yeah, nah. You're right. I don't mean that. At all.
I got it. Let's do The Man Who Sold the World. So we're covering Nirvana, covering David Bowie.
A cover of a cover.
Actually, we can't do that one because the original is from the 70s, so we'd get disqualified.
I'm ready.
But since it's an awesome song, let's just jam it right now anyway.
We passed upon the stairs. Although I wasn't